We begin again with news of a massacre in America. This time, a deadly rampage turned a holiday party into horror. It happened Wednesday at a social service center in San Bernardino, California. 14 people were killed. Another 17 are hurt. Hundreds of people evacuated the complex after the shooters fired.
The suspects are a married couple. Police killed them a few hours later in a violent confrontation about a mile from the shooting scene. One officer was wounded. We have a team of correspondents covering all angles of this story, starting with Nora O'Donnell, who's on the scene at the Inland Regional Center in San Bernardino. Nora, good morning.
Hey, good morning to you, Gail and Charlie. You know, this was supposed to be a happy occasion, a holiday banquet, but it suddenly turned into an active shooter scene. We're actually learning some more details this morning about the people who were inside the building at the time. Also, there is new information this morning about the husband and wife team who police say organized this massacre. So we're going to start with Carter Evans, who is here with me. Carter, good morning.
Nora, the suspects are dead now. They were killed in a rampage 2 hours, a couple of hours after the shooting. Now, one police officer was injured in that shootout. He is in the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. As for the reason behind the massacre, that is still a mystery.
The response out here is immense.
The first reports of gunfire came at around 11 a.m. local time. Police say there were two assailants, a man and a woman.
They came prepared to do what they did as if they were on a mission.
Each suspect had a long gun, a pistol, tactical type clothing that was loaded with magazines, extra magazines for a gunfight.
Just a bunch of shots, multiple shots, shots going off like crazy, just one right after the other.
This man's wife could see the building where San Bernardino County employees were attending a holiday party.
What did your wife see?
The guy outside, dressed all in black with a big gun, just shooting at the window.
Terry Pettit's daughter, Holly, texted him from inside the building.
Shooting at my work, people shot, in the office waiting for cops.
But she's okay.
Pray for us.
Some of the injured were treated at a triage center outside, while others were being evacuated by law enforcement, as caught on this cell phone video.
I'll take a bullet before you do, that's for damn sure. Just be cool, okay?
The assailants escaped, and authorities placed all local government buildings on lockdown. They reported a black SUV fleeing the scene, and approximately 4.5 hours later, at around 3:30 local time, police hunting for the killers riddled a black SUV with gunfire in a shootout caught on police scanner audio.
San Bernardino and Shedden, we can see one guy down. There's one guy in the back of a car.
People living nearby quickly took cover.
We started like ducking down and then they started shooting again further down the street over there. I held bullets, just a rain of bullets everywhere.
The two suspects killed were identified as 28-year-old U.S.-born Saeed Farouk and his wife, Tashfeen Malik. Authorities still haven't determined a motive for the assault.
I think that based upon what we have seen and based upon how they were equipped, there had to have been some degree of planning that went into this. So I don't think they just ran home, put on these types of tactical clothes, grabbed guns, and came back on a spur-of-the-moment thing.
Now, three explosive devices were found inside the building. They were all connected together, all believed to be real, and they were later detonated by the bomb squad. As for those who were injured, Nora, authorities are not releasing any details on the extent of their injuries.
We'll probably learn more about that this morning. Carter, thank you so much.